Good afternoon, esteemed guests and families of Wootton's graduating class of 2022. Thank you so much for joining us this afternoon. We will begin our ceremony momentarily, but before we do, I would like to ask for your assistance. At this time, please silence your phones. Also, please be reminded that noisemakers are not permitted. And we ask that you refrain from excessive celebration as we announce our graduates. We want to make sure that all of our graduates' names are heard on this momentous occasion. Thank you so much for being here and celebrating Wootton's class of 2022.
Please remain standing for the presentation of the colors. Please be seated.
Took a hard left, but we're all right.
Yeah, sure can try to pull out through, but we built this rise up.
Nothing's ever gonna move it.
Our bones are good, rest don't matter. Pain could heal, glass could shatter. Let it rain, cause you and I remain the same.
Cry
Good afternoon, Principal Bolden, teachers, staff, family, and most importantly, my fellow graduating class, the Wootton High School class of 2022. We made it! Before we begin, I would personally like to thank all of the students for putting their trust in me as your class president for these past 4 years. It has been a prodigious honor, and I hope I lived up to the great expectations placed upon our grade. I'd also like to thank the creators of PhotoMath, Google Translate, and Quizlet on behalf of the class. Now to begin. As the great Master Oogway once stated, yesterday is history, tomorrow is a mystery, but today is a gift. That's why we call it the present. Our class has overcome a lifetime worth of challenges within just the past 3 years. The pandemic, the overall polarization, and countless global conflicts. Despite the odds, here we are today. Despite the global pandemic's wrath, here we are today. Despite the 13 years of the daily grind, here we are today. Our class is the epitome of resilience and really demonstrates the core idea that if you can imagine it, you can achieve it. Our years together were a test, not a test to find out who is best, but a test to understand what to do with the rest. When we first came to Wootton, we came from a multitude of middle schools and over a dozen different elementary schools. At first, many formed predictable groups and cliques, but over time, we came together as we fought opposing schools on the football field, rallied together at the band competitions and pep rallies. And I'll personally always fondly remember how senior planning beat SGA in tug of war in every single pep rally. Now, when you look around, you don't think of us as Cabin John or Frost, but rather as fellow Wootton Patriots. As former principal Dr. Doran always used to say, once a patriot, always a patriot. Thus, experience is the only school from which one does not graduate. Let us take this experience gained from 13 years of friendships, classes, and assignments into the next steps of our lives, stronger than we began. Graduates, this graduation is not the end, but rather just the beginning. Take pride in how far you have come, have faith in how far you will go, and don't forget to enjoy your journey. For the final time, thank you from your guy, Dylan Safai. Peace out, Patriots.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Kirthi Padmanabhan, and I have had the honor to serve as your vice president for the past 4 years. Now, starting high school, I was a mere 5 feet and 1 inch tall. Now, as I speak to you on this podium, I stand at a tall 5 feet and 2 inches. Oh, and 3/4 of an inch. Now, what do we call this? Growth. But the best demonstration of true growth has happened at Wootton High School. I have seen us mold into strong, charismatic individuals through our shared experiences together. Whether it's making endangered species posters, cheering so loud for your teammates that you lose your voice the next morning, or putting together our one-of-a-kind class floats, we have formed unbreakable bonds with the 480 people who were once strangers 12 years ago. Such bonds have helped us explore who we are as individuals and have helped us create lasting memories. Lit, crazy, movie. Just three of the words I would use to describe high school. I will laugh remembering seeing the Wootton Loves Hot Dog Water sign plastered on the stadium wall during homecoming week and miss the conversations in the car before school, science photo shoots during lab days, and midnight phone calls cracking jokes with a side of calculus problems. I guess we could really say that high school was a movie. But even the best movies have their fair share of plot twists. I am grateful for the little things, like having teachers to talk to during office hours, grateful for friends who made the pandemic seem not so lonely. There are many, many things I may never understand in this crazy world we live in, like just how football games work, In all honesty, I've gotten away with just cheering when everyone else does, and that seems to work, so I'm not going to question it. But coming out of high school, we leave with a strong understanding of ourselves and community. Our understanding of the communities we have shaped and built in the past 4 years, support, empathy, and camaraderie, are just some of the things that we will carry with us for the rest of our lives and will help us make a positive difference. Whether that's making schools safer for students and teachers or a world safer for women. And we owe much of this to none other than our principal, Ms. Bolden. Grateful for all that you have done in uplifting each and every one of us from the very beginning, we will miss you deeply next year, and we are so incredibly honored to be your last graduating class of Wootton. Although Adele is quite famous for saying hello, it's time for me to say goodbye up here on the podium and give a warm, warm welcome to our wonderful, supportive, and most of all kind, Principal Bolden.
Thank you, Kathy. Good afternoon, and welcome esteemed guests, families, friends, and of course, the class of 2022. It is truly my honor to welcome you to Thomas S. Wootton's commencement ceremony. I am beyond thrilled to be in this historic and most beautiful venue to celebrate this tremendous milestone in your journey. I am joined on stage today by several representatives from our school system who have worked tirelessly on behalf of all students in Montgomery County Public Schools. Their investment in you has been unwavering, so please join me in welcoming Ms. Lynn Harris, member of the Board of Education, Mr. Jimmy D'Andrea, Chief of Staff of Montgomery County Public Schools, Dr. Jeannie Dawson, Chief Office of Finance and Operations, and Dr. Jen Webster, Director of Learning, Achievement, and Administration. And of course, I would like to extend a warm welcome to our guest speaker and proud Wootton alumni, Professor Lucy Delglish, Dean of the Philip Merrill College of Journalism at the University of Maryland. Welcome, and thank you all for being here this afternoon. Graduates, from the very first moment you began kindergarten all the way through your high school years, you were guided by a devoted and compassionate group of educators who set the course for your formative lessons. They were your early influencers, teaching you about the importance of compassion, kindness, friendship, and hard work and perseverance. And here with us today are the elementary and middle school principals representing the Wootton Cluster. Will the following Wootton Cluster principals please stand and be recognized? Ms. Natalie Hambrick, Cold Spring Elementary. Mr. Greg Barron, Dufif Elementary. Ms. Christina Lee, Falls Mead Elementary. Ms. Deb Berner, Lakewood Elementary. Dr. Kim Williams-Cassio, Stone Mill Elementary. And Dr. Karen Wade, Travella Elementary. In addition to our elementary principals here today, we are also joined by two principals who saw you through your middle years. Please stand, Ms. Summer Snyder, Principal of Cap'n John Middle School, and Dr. Joey Jones, Principal of Robert Frost Middle School. Also in the audience, we are pleased to acknowledge several honored guests who have joined us today. Please extend a warm welcome to Senator Cheryl Kagan, Maryland State Senate, District 17. Mrs. Susan Schenck, retired Travella Principal. And two former Wootton staff members, Mr. Neil Cleese and Ms. Teresa Dethelson. When you arrived at Wootton 4 years ago, Wootton's faculty and staff continued to build upon those early lessons and provided you with spaces to grow, to be challenged, to succeed, and to fail, to understand the importance of asking questions and to stretch yourself beyond what you thought was possible. They have played a significant role in your success, and their guidance, unconditional positive regard, and knowledge cannot be easily stated or measured. Would the faculty and staff of Wootton High School please stand and be recognized? Wootton's administrative team are extraordinarily hardworking and dedicated individuals. Ms. De La Rosa, Ms. Walker, Mr. Roner, Mr. Hitchens, thank you for your continued and persistent support of all of our students, staff, and families. And I would like to give a special thanks to Mr. Joe Mamana, the class of 2022's proud administrator. Mr. Mamana has been your biggest advocate and support in all ways. You will be his last class as he is set to retire at the end of this year. Thank you, Mr. Mamana, for shepherding the class of 2022 to their graduation today. To Ms. Rice, our graduation coordinator, Ms. Stepling, Ms. Lang, the Patriot ambassadors, and our senior class officers and planners and student government leaders, thank you for your work to ensure a beautiful ceremony for our graduates. And to Ms. Eckerly, Ms. Herman, Mr. Schwartz, and our very talented musicians, I thank you. I would also like to thank Ms. McCarthy and Ms. Hoskins for taking on the awesome task of being your class sponsors. Their dedication as your class sponsors have been a labor of love. And to the parents of the class of 2022, congratulations. You have been a constant support, cheerleader, advocate, protector. You have been that soft landing place when times were difficult, and you have been that sounding board when they needed it most. We have worked in partnership, parents, to arrive at this most satisfying conclusion. Graduates, please take this moment and give your parents a round of applause. Class of 2022, this is the seventh time that I've had the privilege of delivering remarks to a graduating class. My preparation for these remarks begin early as I try to capture moments throughout the year of what makes each individual class unique, while also thinking about how each class contributes to Wootton's long legacy of excellence. It should come as no surprise that the class of 2022 has contributed to Wootton's tradition of excellence in all the ways that you have pursued your academic interests, your passions, and your curiosities. By participating in our advanced placement program, humanities and the arts, STARS, dual enrollment, AOIT, our Education Academy, Thomas Edison High School of Technology, and our early college program, just to name a few, you have pursued your own paths and forged new ones. Amongst our graduates today, we have 45 Governor's Merit Scholastic Award winners, 19 National Merit finalists, a National Merit Scholarship recipient, and 4 National Merit Special Scholarship recipients. We have 54 graduates qualifying for the Maryland Seal of Biliteracy, 8 early college graduates, and 4 graduates appointed to the U.S. Naval Academy, and 2 graduates appointed to the U.S. Air Force Academy. All of your efforts amounted to over $39 million in scholarships and awards. You went above and beyond in volunteering in our communities when we need it most. We have 136 seniors earning the Certificate of Meritorious Service for completing 240 or more hours of service. And we have 5 students, Maya Cheller, Danielle Lee, Brian Kim, Nikki Ferrugi, and Dylan Safai, earning 1,000 SSL hours. you were equally talented in the athletic department. In the fall, this class helped our school receive 2 county championships in girls soccer and girls volleyball, with our girls volleyball team winning the regional and advancing to the state playoffs. Our girls basketball advanced to the regional finals. Our boys and girls swim and dive 200-meter freestyle relays won a state title. And let's go. Indeed, let's go. And our bocce team also won their division. Our wrestling team and senior Jasmine Gong finished 3rd in the state. Our track and field placed in several competitions in the states, while our girls and boys tennis teams are regional and state champions with Jacob Asterowitz and Helena Saraculia both clinching the single state championship 2 years in a row. We had over 1,800 students participate in athletics over 3 seasons with a cumulative GPA of 3.45. We will have 13 student athletes going on to play sports in college. You were impressive in our publications department, whether you kept our community informed by your reporting skills on our newspaper, Common Sense, or you shared beautiful poetry, artwork, and original works in Pulp, our literary magazine, or you captured how we changed gears in this year's yearbook, Fife and Drum. You shared your artistic, journalistic, and creative passions with the wider school community. You made beautiful music this year. The Department of Instrumental Music had a very successful year because of our students' perseverance and resilience. The marching band gave the first performance of our season in August at the new student orientation and picnic after being sidelined the entire previous year. The marching band performed 15 times for all home football games. Our bands and orchestras also performed at the MCPS adjudication, where all ensembles earned the highest rating possible, all superiors. The Wind Ensemble represented Wootton and MCPS at the inaugural Mid-Atlantic Regional Concert Band Festival, where once again, they earned the highest ratings possible. Our Wootton Acatonics a cappella group placed 1st in the International Championship of High School a cappella Mid-Atlantic Quarterfinal for the 3rd year in a row and made Wootton history by being the first group to perform live at the semifinal round in New Jersey. Elizabeth Ipe. Elizabeth Ive represented Wootton, Montgomery County, and the state of Maryland after having the honor of being accepted to the All-National Choir. And our drama department brought our theater back with an outstanding performance of The Little Mermaid this spring. All of these accomplishments by our graduating class and so much more contributed positively to the fabric of Wootton High School. Graduates, over the years, in the final moments of my address, I've spoken directly to the graduating class, and my messages have focused on doing your best, being kind to one another, remaining connected to your larger community, having resilience and perseverance, and finding your way to contribute to something greater than yourselves. As you wait anxiously to receive your diploma and close this chapter to begin a new one, my hope for you is that you remain present in this moment. Take it in. At the end of one journey and the beginning of a new one, there is the briefest moment to savor all that you have accomplished, to reflect on the lessons you have learned, and to have gratitude for the people and experiences that have gotten you here. And after you have had time to enjoy this moment with your loved ones and friends and classmates, go confidently into your next chapter, knowing that you will take with you the most valuable lessons of friendship, hard work, kindness, and connection. Look forward to the new journey with optimism and hope, and be sure to do your part to contribute positively to this world. And while you will continue to experience change, challenge, and difficulties, know that you are well prepared to face them. And at the end of all of your journeys, just like this one, there is joy, happiness, and satisfaction awaiting you. Class of 2022, thank you for making Wootton your community for the past 4 years and for leaving Wootton a greater place because of your contributions. And on a personal note, it has been an honor and a privilege to serve this remarkable community as your principal for the past 7 years. I wish you only the best as you move forward, and congratulations on your graduation today. And always, always remember, patriots rule. Thank you. Now, I have one more task before I take my seat and before Ms. Harris comes up. Ms. Harris, on behalf of the faculty and staff of Thomas S. Wootton High School, I recommend to you the members of the class of 2022 as qualified candidates for the State of Maryland Diploma. Thank you, everyone. Congratulations.
Good afternoon, everyone. My name is Jasmine Gong, and I am so excited and so unqualified to give you all some life advice today. Admittedly, I had a lot of difficulty writing this speech. Maybe because of the senioritis, but frankly, because I am no more prepared for the future than any of you here. I may appear esteemed or put together, but underneath these cords and stoles is, well, first off, a really fire jumpsuit. But an individual who often went to our counseling office for emotional support has no idea what she wants to do with her life. Had a spicy chicken patty sandwich thrown at her car. If there's anything you take away from my speech, please let it be my reminder that everyone in this room goes through periods where they are just going through it. And guess what? That's normal. We should feel comforted by the fact that we all experience anxiety, loneliness, fear. You know, all the fun emotions that come with life. Always remember that comparison is the thief of happiness. We wish for the qualities we see in others, but our criticism towards ourselves leaves us unsatisfied with our life. But the facade we see on social media or is overheard by our parents on WeChat or WhatsApp is such a minuscule portion of people's lives. It's the idealized and curated version that covers the true, vulnerable, perhaps even ugly aspects of our lives that we don't like to share. Just think about that poor girl who had just finished sobbing in Ms. Taylor's office, trying to book her first therapy appointment in her dented 2010 Honda Civic, as a spicy chicken patty sandwich gets catapulted towards her back window. That's the duality of being a girl boss. Being able to cry in my car and also stand before you today. Don't ever feel pressured to be like or go at the same pace as the people around you. Everyone is going through experiences you are unaware of. Everyone is human. And speaking of girl bosses, I would like to introduce you to our commencement speaker, She's the Dean of the Philip Merrill College of Journalism at the University of Maryland and a Wootton alumna. Please give a warm welcome to Professor Lucy Dalglish.
Hello, Patriots. Thank you very much for inviting me to be your commencement speaker. I've listened to many commencement addresses as a dean, but to deliver one, this is a first for me, and I'm very, very honored. Throughout the summer, well, first, let me tell you, okay. I walked in here, and I've not been in Constitution Hall since they remodeled and spruced it up. You guys look spectacular with the blue and the red accents. You're made for this room. Throughout the summer, I try to speak to every group of recent high school graduates and their parents coming through the Philip Merrill College of Journalism for freshman orientation. And I hope that in a couple of weeks, I'll see some of you on campus as well. In preparing this speech, I asked one group of rising freshmen who arrived for orientation what I should say to you today. Jack from Long Island suggested I tell you, "You got this." Well, he was right. I'm confident that you are prepared for whatever life brings you. But I have a hunch that you wanted just a little bit more than that out of me. So here are a few other thoughts. I have spent the past 25 years working with young people, just like you. They were seeking their place in the world. And as the dean of a terrific journalism school for the last 10 years, I have watched our graduates use their college educations in many ways. And increasingly, I've been paying close attention to high school graduates who find ways to excel in our society by going to trade schools or relying on their high school educations. Some of you will be joining the military, and we will be very, very grateful for your service. All of you have so much in common, yet you will find different paths through life. I've learned a couple of basic things about your generation. First, you're smart, very, very scary smart. And second, you are passionate and compassionate. I have seen your passion as you attend marches supporting women's rights, climate action, and other causes that are important to you. I have seen your compassion as you volunteer to work for food banks and to raise scholarship money for your classmates. So you've definitely got passion and compassion in abundance. But that's not all you will need. High school graduates go out into a big, scary, complicated world where they are exposed to new ideas, new cultures, civil unrest, and plenty of jerks. Sometimes you will be overwhelmed and just yearn to feel safe from it. As Jasmine said, that's totally normal. But I want you to use the skills and tools you have learned at Wootton High School to stride confidently into the future. There are four additional life skills that I think you should focus on for the remainder of your lives. First, be curious. Be curious about your communities, curious about the people you meet in higher education and in professional settings. And please, please, be curious about the rest of the world. I found that the best part of being a journalist is that I never stopped learning. As you learn, you grow. Be curious about human experiences and beliefs that may be different from your own. Those experiences and beliefs might offend you, they might frighten you, they might provoke you, and they just might inspire you. Hang in there. It's the people who have inspired me that I remember the most vividly since my high school graduation. To be inspired, you must be curious about the world around you. So please make it a practice to explore. places, people, ideas, and cultures. The second skill I want you to develop is discernment. The Oxford Dictionary defines discernment as the ability to judge well. Our nation has never needed citizens able to discern more than it does today. When I graduated from high school and college, most of what I learned about the world was told through the lens of my family, professional journalists, and teachers who had been educated and trained to gather truthful information and share it with others. Compared to today, the information channels were very limited. And in some ways, a few ways, I think we were better off. Today, American democracy is in crisis. And one of the many reasons for that is the relentless mix of truth with garbage on the internet. The lack of trust in our basic democratic institutions, including our election system, our public schools, and the news media, are threats to American democracy. This summer, my faculty members are seeking a research grant to investigate ways we can promote democracy. In that grant application, we're arguing that in a democracy, citizens use the information they gather to make decisions at the ballot box. Self-governance depends on shared facts and informed citizens to create a common understanding of the common good. We must be capable of finding, processing, analyzing, and communicating accurate information if we are to understand and solve the problems facing our communities. And we must have enough trust in each other and in our public servants and institutions to believe we can and should work together to solve problems. None of this is possible when anti-democratic threats and vulnerabilities, particularly threats from false information, are pervasive. Now, I won't ask you to stop reading things you find on the internet. That would be silly. But please, as you go through life, take a course in media literacy or take some time to learn how to identify independent, reputable sources of information. There is so much damaging information out there from folks who want to do all of us great harm. You must learn to discern. Third, please practice appreciation. We have all been through 5 semesters of anxiety, stress, and exhaustion. You will forever be known as the class that got hit with the pandemic 3 out of your 4 years of high school. Some of you lost family members and friends to COVID-19, and I am so sorry for your loss. Through the worst of COVID-19, I was heartened to witness the compassion of students and their families and their teachers and the care they showed each other. I hope you stay compassionate throughout your life, but let's talk about appreciation for a minute. Over the summer, send your favorite teacher or mentor a note. They have had a tough time the past couple of years. You have witnessed their Herculean efforts to make sure you got the best education possible during the pandemic. Trust me on this. You are their pride and joy. Your successes are their successes. Let them know you appreciate them. And while you're at it, please tell your parents how much you appreciate them. They have been frightened for the last 2 years, trying to balance concern for your family's health, with your need to get a good education. You've all seen the balancing act. People lost their jobs, people were sick, some of your teachers were probably trying to take care of their small children in the background. It's been tough. Finally, be fearless. Those of you who are University of Maryland Terrapin supporters know one of the slogans on our campus, fear the turtle. That somewhat crazy slogan is actually something I encourage you to model. Did you know that the terrapin cannot move backwards? It can only go forward, sticking its neck out, moving fearlessly forward, one small step at a time. Try new things, travel to new places, talk to your neighbors, study and appreciate races, genders, and religions that are different from your own. Explore cultures here and abroad. Don't let yourself get into a rut. And for those of you going to college, if you don't like the first major you try in college, change. It's a perfect time to do that. Similarly, if you don't like your first real job, try something else. Heck, I'm on my fourth career. It's been great. So be fearless. You are a unique individual in this complicated world of ours. We need your special gifts and talents. Show the world who you are. So please seek the truth. Listen, really listen to others. Explore the world. Learn and grow. We need you. And in the words of one of my favorite country music stars, Tim McGraw, please be humble and kind. Thank you.
First, I would like to start by asking you all a question. Has anyone heard of saving the best for last? Good afternoon, graduates, families, and friends. My name is Nikki Farugi, and I have been enrolled in Montgomery College's Early College Program for the past 2 years, and also have had the pleasure of serving as the senior class secretary. I am the last officer to be giving a speech, so we are now one step closer to walking across the stage. Now I want my classmates to close their eyes. I mean it, close their eyes, physically close them. Maya, I see your eyes are still open. Now think back to the first day of kindergarten, then to fifth and eighth grade promotion. Now think back to the first day of high school. Do you remember how old those seniors looked? Well, here we are now. You can open your eyes. After 13 long years, we are finally those old seniors. We are the seniors of Thomas Wootton High School. Today is a day that we are entering into a new chapter of our lives. Every day is going to be different, like the weather. One day is cloudy, while the other is sun and warm. Some days might feel like the longest day ever, while some might feel like the shortest. It's important to remember that none of these days last forever, neither the happy sunny days nor the stormy dark days. Stay positive and be hopeful. Have faith and have respect. I would be lying if I said I didn't have moments this year where I asked myself, is my grade really going to be affected if I don't do this homework assignment? Or, I'll just do better on the next quiz or exam. Just make sure you all make good choices on your future endeavors. If you didn't pay attention to anything I just said, because I know you guys are all excited to walk across the stage, just remember that you are braver than you believe, stronger than you seem, smarter than you think, and of course, loved more than you'll ever know. On behalf of the class of 2022, thank you all, Ms. Bolden, Mr. Romana, staff and parents, for your unconditional support for the past 4 years. We could not have done it without you all. Now I'd like to introduce Ms. Lynn Harris. She is a pillar of the Montgomery County School community. From being a lawyer to a nurse and even being the current member of Board of Education, we are so proud to have her here with us today. Everyone, please give a warm welcome to Ms. Lynn Harris.
Thank you, Nikki. And I want to start by once again saying thank you to the amazing musicians that made, really enriched the ceremony today. Really, the singers, the musicians. Clearly there is a very strong tradition of musical excellence at the school. Maybe some of you saw Sunday night's Tony Awards for a very recent alum of yours representing. And I just couldn't help but think, as Dr. Dugleish was talking about, the fact that you all, Common Sense, Pulitzer quality student newspaper. Yeah. So congratulations, class of 22. And congratulations to the families that supported you in your journeys, both the families that you were born into and the families that you made along the way. And I think one of the things that I did when I found out that I was going to have the privilege of once again representing the Board of Education at the Wootton High School graduation, last year the first one I ever did was Wootton, class of 21, and at least we're not batting cicadas today. But so I had an opportunity to come and meet with some of your student leaders and ask them just, what is it about your time at MCPS that you most remember? What's most influenced you? What's most impacted you? The good, the bad, the ugly. And, you know, they talked about the fact that, you know, as has been mentioned, you all are the pandemic class, right? Except for your freshman year, all of your educational time in high school was really deeply impacted by a global pandemic that was not within your control. And students talked about the fact that that was a huge challenge, and you all know it was a huge challenge. However, that challenge built in you a sense of true resilience and the ability to problem solve and the ability to think outside the box. And one of the things that was kind of a through line in lots of conversations with students was that that pandemic gave you unexpectedly the gift of time. You had a lot of time that you didn't think you were going to have. And you filled it in lots and lots of different ways. Spent more time with your families. Mastered new skills. I think we hear all across the world about people who found themselves with lots of extra time and learned how to do things they'd always wanted to learn how to do. But one thing that I heard over and over again from the students in Montgomery County is that they used that time to speak to the issues that they cared about, to become powerful advocates, speaking with passion and substance about all manner of issues affecting you and your future. Gun violence, gender inclusion, food insecurity, climate change and sustainability, hate in all its forms, and you became important and powerful influencers, and you've changed this county. And I can tell you directly, you've changed the school system for the better. And one of the things, too, that has come back is you all said you had a new appreciation for things you probably took for granted before, like just being able to walk into the building every day and see your friends. A homecoming game, you know, being able to go to a party, the marching band to be able to perform, having being able to perform on the stage again. And because of that new appreciation, you expanded your horizon and you made the year one that was more than you had expected it could ever be. You followed old traditions, created new ones. But one of the things you also spoke to that you most appreciated about your experience of MCPS was its diversity. And I hope you are leaving us with a solid, broad foundation of learning, because over the past several years, we've all seen very directly the dangers of a closed mind. And the most powerful antidote to a closed mind is a broad education that makes you think outside your bubble and experience and get to know individuals whose lives and experiences and paths are different from your own. So one of the things I'm going to leave you with, three challenges. Because one of the things you, the students of Montgomery County Public Schools, told the school system it needed to do to be a better, more relevant system was to have a workforce that was truly diverse, truly inclusive, truly reflective of who we are as a county. And you spoke very directly about the things you wanted to see to make every single school a place where every single person, every single day, felt safe and welcome and valued and seen for being exactly who they are. So, as I look forward as somebody deeply invested in the future of the school system, what you've told me we need to be the best school system we can be, you all possess. You are the best future that this school system could possibly have. And so my first challenge to you is, whatever your life journey is, wherever you go next, whatever doors you open and turns you take as you ponder your life and your career choices, if you think building a life in Montgomery County is something that you want to do, think about coming back to this school system and helping make it the best system it can be. Right? So some of you may be saying, well, you know, teacher, I haven't really thought about being a teacher. And yes, teachers are the foundation of the work that we do. Teachers, paraeducators, special educators, yes. If you are thinking about being a teacher, I want to talk to you. But we are an enormous school system. We are the biggest employer in Montgomery County. This is a business. We need accountants, financial analysts, financial planners. We need business managers. We have the biggest bus fleet in the state of Maryland, which we are converting to fully electric, thanks in part to your advocacy. So we need mechanics that know how to maintain that bus fleet. We've heard you loud and clear, we're gonna fix the food. And so we need nutritionists, dietitians, chefs, come back to us. We need engineers and architects. We have a huge array of buildings that we have to keep and maintain. We need building service managers. We need plumbers and carpenters and HVAC technicians. We build buildings. We need architects and engineers. So consider possibly bringing your talent back to us sometime in the future. Challenge number two, some of you that are like, well, what would that be like? What would that be like? Well, I can tell you a way you can find out what it would be like to work for our school system. So I'm looking around and I see Nikki was one of them. Some of you are among the 268 very impressive MCPS members of the class of 22 who got your associate's degree before you got your high school diploma. So once you have 60 college credits, and those of you who already have your associate's degree, you know you're already there, check that box, you can join our substitute teaching pool and see what it's like. You know, I can tell you, it's a very, very, very flexible opportunity. No nights, no weekends. We just raised the pay. You know, you can think, well, I'm going to school. There are actually a lot of recent alumni of this school system who have come back, and during their college breaks, during summers, and again, substitute teachers year-round with our innovative school calendar schools and summer school. Very flexible opportunity just to see what it's like and get to know us from the inside, because, you know, you all have great insight into what makes a classroom engaging and fun for our littlest learners to the class of 23. So think about that. And the third and last challenge is this. So you have learned to be incredibly powerful advocates and influencers, speaking to the issues you care about. So Mahatma Gandhi said you have to be the change you want to see in the world. And you all have shown you are willing to do that. Well, one of the ways to be the change is to be the decision maker. So, five numbers. 18, 21, 25, 30, 35. 18, the age you need to be to run for office in Montgomery County. 21, the age you need to be to run to be a Maryland state delegate. 25, the age you need to be to run for Congress and run for the Maryland State Senate. 30, the age you need to be to run for the U.S. Senate and to run to be governor of the state of Maryland. 35, the age you need to be to run to be president of the United States. So I hope in the future I will see some of your names on ballots, standing up to be the decision makers to reflect that way of being the change, and the sooner the better. Now, the legal part, so you can get the heck out of here. By virtue of the authority vested in the Board of Education of Montgomery County under the laws of the state of Maryland, I do now award diplomas or certificates evidencing the satisfactory completion of prescribed courses of study to the students of the class of 22 of Thomas S. Wootton High School, who are recommended for graduation by the faculty of this school. And in receiving this diploma or certificate, each of you is entitled to all of the privileges and honors accorded graduates of a high school accredited by the Maryland State Department of Education. Congratulations, well done.
Dylan Safai. Kirthi Padmanabhan. Jasmine Gong. Nikki Farugi. Jay Banat. Shelby Cantor. Alexis Chavez, Charlotte Kristovich, Neha Dinadialan, Ethan Fain, Joshua Friedman, Shayna Gittleson, Sophia Good, Allison Gritz, Brooklyn Harry, Olivia Kim, Shayna Kotler, Emily Levine, Rachel Lederman, Nadia Mayorovich, Ethan Moon, Elizabeth Nelson, Desiree Ofori, Yael Rosen, Jane Sanborn, Suhani Singh, Amanda Sludd, Surya Udeshankar, Nicole Wasserman. Catherine Wood. Eva Yegyang. Ryan Binder. Maya Chillar. Catherine Cowan. Nicholas DePalma. Liana Berhane. Elizabeth Jack. Nathan Jacobs. Simon Kidane. Daniel Lee. Jamie Morris. James Moo. Christopher Yeh. Nicholas Jones. Roshni Arun. Justin Wang. Jordan Kolsani. Aiden Hu. Elizabeth Eip. Luke Jordan. Meghna Krishnan. Jean-Jacques Shimo. Divya Philippos. Isra Kadri. Nicholas Chu. Jamie Ryer. Helen Sorikulaya. Michael Seibert. Alejandro Zubiate Salmon. Reza Abedia. Kim Abera. Ashita Adarsh. Edna Adisu. Venus Afkami. Umar Ahmed. Faderera Finfi Akinfe. Nadia Alarif. Reina Ali. Manav Alampalam. Ryan Amon. Luis Araujo. Eric Arvizu. Kirthana Avaru. Izzy Ayaroa. Shaheen Bagai Vaji. Divya Bakshi. Jonathan Barrow. Riley Batkin. Samuel Bodet. Nehemiah Beeks. Sydney Behrens. Jordan Bellot. Johannes Berhane Selassie. Nahom Berhane. Sonia Berlinger. Samuel Bett. Alan Balunga. Richard Black. Harris Blumberg. Lance Boak. Samantha Bowles. Noah Book. Sarah Boring. Lucas Bowen. Naomi Brown. Jackson Brunner. Lawrence Boo. Natalie Burns. Tyler Bush. Ryan Butler. Aiden Caesar. Allison Cow. Robert Carpenter. Alicia Cathy. Walter Cedarbrandt. Adam Chuckier. Samuel Chow. Srijato Chatterjee. Mathis Chavez. Amber Chen. Jerry Chen. Ronald Chen. Nancy Chen. Elaine Chang. Caitlin Chang. Trevor Cohen. Sijun Chung. Z Chang. Rachel Chung. Cade Christensen. Benjamin Christovich. Caitlin Chuang. Beatrice Chung. Julianne Chechvia Elias. Casey Claxton. Ethan Cohen. Natasha Collinson. Ella Cooper. Daniela Catone. Josephine Crocker. Anna Darby. Jamin Day. Justin DeLeon. Ryan Denio. Amal Dhaliwal. Sarah Dumboya. Jake Dreikerman. Shinbei Du. Mateo LaRota. Kane Duperval. Alex Dupree. Priel Edere. Benjamin Ehrman. Hannah Eisenfeld. David Engel. Alexandra Erichta. Sanaya Lipford. Jacob Esterowitz. Joshua Euler. Fatia Ave. Keon Fazi Marandi. Alan Findy. Sky Fofana. Micah Fawcett. Sophie Friedman. Omar Fuentes. Valentina Trinidad Gonzalita Pino. Claire Fuller.
Renata Gabrahamnova. Nicholas Gaines. Yelena Garcia. Sage Gardner. Vanshika Garg. Jonah Geisner. Rosa Gaderi. Katie Golly. Max Glazer. Jake Gluck. Daniel Golabi. Spencer Golub. Max Gracialny. Devin Graham. AJ Granger. Sam Gross. Sinduja Gudor. Giselle Guillen. Adeline Gully. Iris Guo. Matthew Guo. Zaria Outen. Angel Martinez. Jihoon Ha. Karina Hafiz. Brett Halpern. Wesley Hung. Helena Hansen. Amir Puyan Hushemi. Tessa Helgeson. Morgan Hendrickson. Amanda Henmuller. M. Leo Hertzler. Ethan Hill. Layla Hilmi. Trevor Hoke. Rachel Hong. Madison Hosking. Feng Fu Ho. Emily Hoyle. Athena Shui. Huda Hussein. Humna Ibrahim. Advait Iyer. Hyunsa Zhang. Nicole Jezik. Kelly G. Kevin Jang. Eric Joe. Diamond Jones. Richard Jones. Kyle Jordan. Logan Judelson. Chelsea Kabunji. Jill Chelsea Kaji Teju. Judah Kamadinata. Dare Kang. Rashmi Kanipakala. Jay Cannon. Sophia Kaplanovich. Alexandra Kapustina. Altiab Karar. Gail Karimi. Eknor Kaur. Samantha Keller. Anna Keneally. Kathleen Kearns. Tammy Kesselman. Elena Conlarbake. Michael Payne. Aditya Khanna. Isla Corsand. Kenyanat Kotsani. Brian Kim. Jean Kim. Ryan Kim. Paul Kim. Samantha Kimbis. Ava Kamiya. Owen King. Joseph Kiriakis. Gabriel Klein. Giselle Kleinbusink. Logan Kolasak. Siddharth Kandam. Sachin Krishna Rogers. Anika Kulkarni. Aditya Kumar. Gina Kumaran. Caitlin Kwan. Rachel Lay. Autumn Lee. Christina Lee. Danielle Lee. Donovan Lee. Elizabeth Lee. Mackenzie Lee. Elizabeth Leonova Havalko. Elena Lee. Benjamin Lee. Kathleen Lee. Max Lee. Grace Liao. James Liskey. Alfred Liljus. Brian Lim. Maggie Lin. Justin Lin. Evan Liu. Michael Loconte. Alexander Lopez. Jake Lotenberg. Bradley Lutz. Dylan Mack. Grace Mahon. Lucas Meyer. Katia Makalu. Nikita Makulov. Manal Malik. Ivan Mamutkin. Ben Margolin. Tatiana Martinez. Charlie Mash. Adil Masood. Caroline Matikian. Natalie Matikian. Rebecca McMillan. Jack Mailer. Faith Mendoza. Xingyu Meng. Ellie Metz. Jonathan Meyer. Karen Miao. Mary Micah. Mia Mikowski. Dason Miller. Liam Miller. Shane Miller. Parth Mishra. Liam Mitchell. Samir Mitri. Thomas Mitri. Alexandra Mockitsturm. Parsa Madaris. Hadia Mohammed. Aria Mohebi. Jaren Mondel. Nicole Montero Merchan. Logan Moore. Jansu Morale. Sofia Moreira. Joaquin Moreno. Jacob Morris. Jack Morrison. Elvin Munn. Nema Munchi.
Jordan Needleman. Salma Negmeldine. Joey Neustadt. Shannon Newell. Andrew Wynn. Madison Nguyen. Tiffany Nguyen. Oluwase Ifumi Obadina. Alex Obolensky. Stephen Ofori Apaya. Zion Okwa. Jerome Onis. Ted Otengo. Blake Palavan. Nathan Pack. Brandon Pan. Saurav Pandey. Nivita Paranthaman. Ryan Parent. Isabel Park. Jack Parsons. Jack Pate. Kaya Puar. Aiden Payne. Carissa Pete. Ethan Podbereski. Norowit Pusantisampan. Shravni Potini Balaji. Usba Kadri. Christopher Cho. Andrea Kispe. Hannah Ra. Talia Rami. Shreya Rajkumar. Alejandra Ramirez. Archit Ravi Shankar. Adam Reed. Eliza Ryder. Ian Reppy. Maybelline Gredamozo. Andrew Reynolds. Angela Roach. James Robertson. Aislinn Roebuck. Charlotte Rollins. Josie Rosenstein. Julius Rubin. Mira Sadaterova. Amber Sadiq. Allison Sanger. Kiran Saha. Anjali Samawedam. Som Samya. Nikhil Sauter. Max Schnur. Chandler Scott. Jenna Seibert. Maya Seiler. Alexandra Semyonov. Rizel Serrano. Hajra Sahad. Nidish Shanmugam. Ariana Shariardi. Aliyah Shemsu. Joshua Sherry. Jonathan Shee. Michael Shiflett. Lily Shirzad. AJ Shumba. Jenna Simon. Liam Simmons. Logan Simmons. Christina Sinclair. Ian Smith. Olivia Smith. Jordan Smith. Veronica Smarodinsev. Melody Sohelina. Jeffrey Song. Joanne Song. Hannah Stearns. Elizabeth Stepanov. Ethan Stoller. Joy Sun. Marilyn Tavener. Dylan Taylor. Jonathan Teklu. Erica Thigpen. Kai Thompson Jones. Krishna Priya Tiparaju. Alexander Kachenko. Julio Torrejon. Alejandro Torres Rangel. Chelsea Tu. Sophie Umansky. Brian Van Wyk Amaya. Diego Velez. Shruta Venkatesan. Shriya Venkatesh. Claire Walker. Isaiah Walker. James Walsh. Brandon Wang. Carolyn Wang. Emily Wang. Henry Wang. Jason Wang. Kristen Wong. Michael Wong. Tim Wong. Noah Weber. Brady Weiss. Riley Wells. Rose Wen. Miles Wiley. Brian Wong. Max Davis Wool. Jiayi Wu. Michelle Xie. Jawei Xie. Marvin Shu. Yi Yao Shu. Iris Yang. Christian Ye. Jack Yielding. Daniel Yi. Dylan Yoon. Michelle Yu. Kira Yuan. David Yoon. Panayoti Zaris. Yurgo Zaris. Sophie Zarate. Samuel Zaslavsky. Andrew Zhang. Jordan Zhang. Elaine Zhang. Daniel Zhao. Hannah Zhu. Mandy Drung. Catherine Sarkisov. Charlie Ching. Sarah Hudson. Arman Salchek. Lily Zweig. And we would also like to end by recognizing our graduates who are celebrating with us virtually this afternoon. Sasha Annabelle. Stefano Bernasconi Marchant. Jeffrey Chen. Om Cordia. Jacob Dolan. Jonathan Dowdy. Akil Gunda. Matthew Kaminsky. Christos Konstantinos Papaspiru. Daniel Kwok. Connor Lang. Rose LaFleur. Justin McGraw, Maxwell Messina, Ashini Murjani, Anouk Pillai, Cade Shear, Varun Sharma, Shreya Singh, Eric Schmunis, and Brad Van Zandt. Congratulations, class of 2022.
Graduates of the class of 2022, please rise.
Now time for a quick 0.5.
As our futures brightly burn, from right to left our tassels turn.
Once a patriot,
always a patriot.
22 out.